Microsoft relationship came about just through scouting different sponsors and sponsorships, and they've been able to actually go to a headquarters.
We're out in Reston, Virginia, at our Microsoft office and our Microsoft Technology Center. This is a showcase facility where we bring a lot of our customers, where I bring a lot of other youth organizations on field trips. And what we did today was we took Maya's kids from the Maya Arts and Technology Foundation on a field trip. Microsoft has partnered with the Maya Foundation and with Maya herself, building a new alliance, a new partnership going forward to where we're going to be assisting her with a program and all types of other future endeavors.
I told Maya, who's a friend of mine, that I wanted to bring all you guys out to our offices and take you on a field trip and show you some good things and to really have Microsoft be a part of Maya's program because she's a special lady doing a lot of great things with you guys.
Today's trip ties directly into the part of her program where she wants to take her students out on field trips, different types of field trips. I know that we are one of some other trips that she's done this summer. And how this ties into her is because this is the technology side.
That's you guys, and that is actually a new meeting device that we're going to be showing you guys today called Roundtable Device. And there's another one in our New York facility, which is down the hall. So we're going to pick a couple of people to go be in New York and have a meeting over there to broadcast back over here. So let's walk around then.
What we did today was we had the kids come in, and one of the first things we did was we set up a meeting. We had one room pretend that they were in New York.
Hi, New York!
Hi, New York!
And one room pretend like they were in Washington, D.C. And between the two rooms, they communicated using something called a roundtable device. And the roundtable device enables you to see video from one side to the other side. And what the kids did was they played different roles in the meeting. Just a lot of hi, how are you, and things like that. But they were still communicating back through over the internet using the roundtable back and forth.
You know what's kind of interesting about this? What's going to happen is in a roundtable device, this is brand new, by the way. No other consumer, you can't buy these right now. They're coming up for sale really, really soon. So these little round table devices, it's the next generation of a speakerphone.
It was a great day. You could see the excitement when we took them into our envisioning center, which is our like a theater surround sound on steroids type of theater.
And the envisioning center is a small theater, seats about 25 people, and there's four vignettes in there, and they're modeling a home, a model home. There's a model office, a model warehouse. And the kids came in and saw what was a portion of the show.
This program here from the British Library actually allows me to go in
and read it.
And read the book. And it feels just like a book. And I can go in, I can zoom in. Now this is in Latin, so it's gonna be actually in Greek, so it's gonna be hard to read, but maybe I wanna read this book and I get just the feeling of just like being there through the internet and enabling that.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
So imagine being able to take these school books, right, instead of carrying those heavy school books in our backpacks, and instead we just load them up and right there on the computer, all you have to do is move your mouse to turn the page.
We showed them in the Microsoft side, unified communications. And showing the unified communications, they were able to get in their email over their phone.
Let me show you something.
You have no new voice messages and two new email messages. Please say voicemail, email.
Email.
Opening your mailbox. First, an unread message from
Tony Smith.
Titled, Thank You, Maya Foundation. We want to thank you for coming to see the Microsoft Technology and Innovation Center. End of message.
We showed off some of the Xbox and some of the more of the consumer type things like the Zoom and things like that. At the Technology Center, because we like showing off our technologies, we get a lot of different schools and different groups that come in. What's special about the Maya Foundation group of kids that came in, First off was the questions that they asked.
Sorry.
Where are the cameras for this?
Okay, where are the cameras for this right here? Let's dive into that right away.
Some of those questions were fantastic. They were questions that are better than some adults have asked inside here.
Do y'all run the Microsoft Word and the Microsoft Excel?
We run Microsoft Word and we run Microsoft Excel. We don't program it. What we do is we show customers how to use it.
Do you work PowerPoints?
We run PowerPoints. Yep, PowerPoint is a Microsoft product. The Excel, Office, or Word, and PowerPoint is part of Microsoft Office. So if you hear us, you have PowerPoint? Oh, isn't that great? I love being able to show PowerPoint.
The thoroughness of the types of questions that they asked was amazing and just blew me away.
Instead of like electricity, is there a wireless energy source you can use for the whole building?
It's not a wireless energy source. I haven't seen any wireless energy sources yet. That would be a great thing to invent. That would be cool.
A couple of those kids in there today asked questions that were totally incredible for to be that age. And you could just see the excitement in their face, how excited they were. We played some of Maya's music, which they loved. So we got to do a whole myriad of things today that these kids will remember for the rest of their lives.
When I was a kid, you know, there were community programs in the summertime or after school, but it really focused on one area. So if I wanted to dance, there was like a dance school. I didn't really know of any centers or programs that focused on many different things at once. I think the closest that came to dealing with computers and art was like a summer camp when I was probably about 10 years old, but it didn't have dance. So I thought I would just give students that didn't necessarily have interest in dance something else, like sound engineering to focus on, or students that didn't necessarily have interest in sound engineering, art and photography skills or life skills class. It's just a well-rounded, well-informative program.
I applaud Maya to the fullest. She has really opened herself up to these boys and girls and allowed them to become better at what they are doing. I have such high opinions of Maya and what she's doing because she didn't have to do it. This lady comes to school and she is sweating when she's teaching this dance class. She's given all of her energy to these boys and girls.
Big thing that Maya's doing that's separating her program from a lot of others is Maya's taking a full range approach of teaching from life skills to arts to implementing technology. And by doing that, she's able to, bottom line, help enrich, enhance, encourage, and empower young people, especially young people in the inner city that a lot of times don't have the opportunity to see and touch certain things.
And then you got the things that she's doing with the kids, the step, she's doing the, where the kids actually get to go in the studios and stuff. That's hands-on experience that they're not going to get at your regular Boys and Girls Club or any other club that you could think of.
This is an educational program also. So it's not just about dancing and music and the arts, but I mean, they have to be, you know, they're educated, their grades are important, they work with these children diligently.
I also wanted to instill that education is everything, even if you do a sport. It takes education, even if you do stand behind a microphone and sing. There's an education in everything you do, and it's necessary to succeed in life.
I was surprised the first week we came. I didn't realize that Maya was going to be actually teaching the classes, and I thought that was great, you know, how she's giving back and she's teaching the kids. She has so much patience with the kids. That really surprised me. It's like they all just gather around her, and she's okay with that.
What was really exciting is to see Miss Maya, you know, really be a part of this foundation, not just to say, hey, I have a foundation, but to really be hands-on and interact with the kids.
Maya herself comes in 3 days a week. She sits there, she gets the class organized, she disciplines them, and she's actually up there herself teaching the class. She doesn't, you know, didn't hire a group, you know, to come, and she shows her face, you know, once, you know, at the end of the summer, says hello and then leaves. She's actually in the class, very hands-on, and individually teaching these students.
Ever since I came to Howard Road and found out that Maya adopted the school and the whole deal, I thought, you know, just the respect I had for her as a recording artist already went up because she's able to give back to the community through her foundation.
It's something new, something different, something positive to bring to the community. And I think it should be more surrounding this community, especially in the Washington, D.C. area.
I support her 100%. I think it's a beautiful thing that she's, you know, giving back to the community, giving back to these kids. And they're so excited to see her. And it just makes them feel so special.
And she's really nice. She's very energetic. She's really good with the kids, and everyone seems to love her.
Really believing in yourself at the end of the day is probably the main focus that I want kids to get out of this experience through the many different classes that we share.
It's making the kids more responsible overall, because Maya has such high expectations. In order to go to the Omega Studios and be a part of that activity, you have to pass a test and understand the different parts of a soundboard. Kids are so eager to understand, and they just want to be a part of this program, so they're learning and they're more responsible. So I think they're walking away from the program being more responsible, and they have learned so much information that will go with them into the future.
Sometimes during the regular day school, you might not have a student, you know, who's social or who's, you know, just the cool kid in school, but when they get a part of something like a group or like the Maya Arts Foundation, you get kids who are, you know, now a part of something, so they feel, you know, they're inspired, they're happy, and just to see the smiles on the kids' faces when they're dancing and the parents coming to see them, they're just ecstatic, and that's kind of what drives me.
I really want to encourage and challenge everyone, being parents, teachers, the community, to get involved with our children's lives. But most of all, stay involved. Programs such as the Maya Arts and Tech Foundation and 21st Century are good programs. They're programs that really help catapult our children's lives.
I think the essentials that teachers and parents instill in a child at an early age can definitely mold their future for the better. And, you know, that's just rewarding in itself if you can do something positive for somebody. And it's as simple as that at the end of the day.
Tell me what is the best she wants. Tell me what is the best she needs. Did you care about the brand new Benz that you just bought for me? Cause y'all didn't have no kids, didn't share no mutual friends. And you told me that she's her kid when y'all broke up in 96. What you gonna do?